Okay. Thank you for coming to the Fertile Brains Poetic Evening with Fertile Brains. I thank one and all on behalf of the entire team of Fertile Brains. Let's get started. Let's sing. Let's wish the world to sing a song of peace. With that, let's roll. I would like to call upon our very first timer. I got a chance to meet her yesterday in Kavi Comedy International Platform, and this is a very delightful experience meeting and listening to her. Her name is she's a senior writer, a lecturer or whatever, I don't know exactly, but then yes, yeah. I would like to welcome Ms. Shalini to say a few words and recite her poem. Welcome, Shalini. Ma'am, kindly unmute your mic. Ma'am, yeah.
I'm Shalini Nankulia, and I live in Kolkata now. So writing is just for me an offering which I do. And I'm a homemaker now, more on a spiritual path. And for now, I just stay at home and pursue all my hobbies, which include painting, singing, and writing. And I'm also a Reiki master. So, and thank you for having me in this group, and it's wonderful. And thank you. It was wonderful to meet you yesterday. And I'm truly grateful here to be among these very illustrious poets and this very creative group. I'm deeply humbled and honored to be here today. So thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Please, could you read your poem so that we could?
Yes. The title of my poem is Beyond the Veil. So, the dark clouds may cover the effulgence of the sun. The dark clouds may cover the effulgence of the sun, but it will soon drift away. But it will soon drift away. The unchanging splendor, the eternal brilliance of the all-pervading, indivisible, resplendent one, the eternal being, will shine through. O mind, why assign labels of pain and pleasure, trials and tribulations? Are they not inherent very nature of this fleeting world of impermanence? Why this endless pursuit of meager joys, the lure of silken desires, the trap of gossamer web, the golden chain of futile coming and going? O mind, awaken from the womb of slumber, the stupor of lulled utopia. Shadows will melt away in the light of knowledge. The mirage of false identity will vanish when the veil is torn asunder. Soar unfettered beyond the skies, beyond the aggregate of all elements, all illusions, where existence, consciousness, bliss, the truth awaits to be revealed. Thank you.
Beautiful, ma'am, beautiful. Roopali, ma'am, would you like to say something? Welcome to the poetic evening. Good evening.
Good evening, Prasanna. Yes, I'm hardly the person to comment on somebody else's poem because it comes so much from their heart. This is a very spiritual poem. You know, you can see a deeply felt spirituality in it. And I think that we are all somehow, you know, returning to ourselves. You know, gradually I can see as I listen to people's poems, you know, I when I saw Alexandra on the show, I know she's going to put up this beautiful, soulful poem also. And so this going inwards, the journey inwards is very, very important, and it's happening to us. And I think that perhaps therein lies peace. Finally, peace that you talked about when we opened this evening, it can only come once we return to ourselves, our real selves, you know. And the divinity is not outside, it's inside us. So thank you so much, Shalini. And I'm so glad you have joined us, because this is a
thank
wonderful
you so
platform.
Much.
Yeah.
And deepest gratitude, Roopali and Prasanna, for this marvelous opportunity.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. And keep coming.
We are so happy to have you.
You could spread the positiveness and positive vibes and everything, you know. I do practice Reiki too.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. That's really wonderful.
When I was 17, 19 years or 17, 18 years old, I learned pranic healing and all. And, you know.
Yes, me too. I've done pranic healing too.
Wow. Well, thank you, ma'am. Thanks on that note. Thanks for your lovely smile. Thanks. Keep coming. Thank you, Roopali, ma'am.
Yes, definitely. Thank you very much. Work. Thank you so much. I'm just thank so you, grateful.
Ma'am. Oh, thank you, ma'am. And now, moving on, let me call upon Scott from USA. Scott is a first timer on our Fertile Brains. So, welcome, Scott. Mic is yours. Here.
Thank you. This is a poem. It's controversial. Got me kicked out of Cultivating Voices. Pushing back. One, an acknowledgement for the folk of the walkaway campaign. Gay, trans, black, white people. Your courage flows, rumbles. Past fences into homes. Poisoned children hear the wind. The waters rising away toward poisoned childhood, wasted life. I reach from here, nowhere. Gay baited, facts didn't matter, but for the spice of falsity. I didn't deny, I armed. Unchecked, bullying is tyranny. Silence is death. Two. Land acknowledgement. History is topography. Respect, live. Aztecs devouring, Lakota displacing. Quote, nation follows nation. Regret is useless, end of quote. History is everyone's homeland. All of us come from someplace else. Three, on woke bigotry history. Once upon a time, Pam Africa reminded me, racism finds its own direction. Bigotries emerge, already ancient. Falseness easier than time. Deafening promises upraise us, if only we will separate. We learn again what we've always seen. Four, the child poisoners, in white coats, in black masks, smashing windows, burning bridges. You live on roaring silence, not in our name. Dragons eat us all, breathe fire, life. Five, addendum, life is woven, knit. Paradox, compromise. Reality is relentless. The world is difficult. History isn't a nice place. Thank you. I hope that wasn't too long.
No. It's brilliant. I would say it's so profound. I think I could go to Richard to, say something about Scott's poem. Richard. Richard, kindly turn on your mic.
Yes, thank you so very much. I really appreciate it. I have a poem about something very beautiful that I saw just yesterday. All of us are concerned about brotherhood, about sisterhood, about caring for those in need, caring for those who've been hurt, who've been brutalized. And there was a big controversy in this country, I'm in America, about statues that have honored villains of the past. You know, we had this great civil war 100 and some years ago, and yet some people still are fighting that war. There's still too much hate. And I saw a wonderful thing yesterday. I was in a southern town, and there on a giant pedestal was nothing. So let me read you this poem that I wrote yesterday about a statue that wasn't there, that was for racism. So the racism has been removed. And if I can share my screen, that'd be marvelous. If not, that's okay. I'll give it a quick try. And then I'll read it, share screen, go. Yep, here we go. It's called the former Confederate statue. A monumental mistake had been made. Oh, what an awful, lawful debt had been paid. A monumental mistake had been made. And there in the city square had been displayed a mark of repression, a scar sadly revealed, no longer concealed, by bravado congealed, an act of kindness, this blindness revealed. The stain of Abel, the issue of Ham, who for centuries long seen forever damned. But mistakes can be corrected, scars can heal, and only the ugliness confession reveals. A monumental mistake had been made and revealed, now slowly healed. Be not afraid. Greatest mistakes, the greatest harm done, even ladders have rungs. Can the repeal once revealed by honesty gave debts can be paid, and all the wrongs and the tallies from porches and back alleys, generations of relations tangled, wrangled, and rallied, a monumental mistake had been made, and now, slowly and surely, gone to its grave, the former statue. Thank you so very much for letting me share. Poets, you build brotherhood and sisterhood. Thank you for all the work that you do.
Indeed, sir, mistakes can be corrected and, you know, wounds can heal, you know. I would say thanks, Scott, for, you know, bringing that poem, and thanks, Richard, for continuing that, you know, in continuation with Scott. And that's a wonderful poem. I would say, I think I could ask, you know, William G. Maveli, who is a first timer on our Fertile Brands. He's a wonderful guy. He's a well-known author. Everybody knows him. And I would ask, welcome William G. Maveli, sir, to the Poetic Evening with Fertile Brands. And kindly, you know, just say a few words about Richard's poem and Scott, if you have listened. And if you have. Can you turn on your mic, sir?
Are you audible now?
Yeah, perfect, sir. Perfect, perfect.
Thank you. I just happened to see this link, and I thought I will just be present there, preferably as a listener, because I am not prepared to recite any poems, but I would like to know how the flow is going around and wish to witness and to have a chat with other wonderful global poets, especially you being a poet also. So this is an opportunity to meet you face to face in this Zoom meeting. And I have a lot of poems in front of me. It's in pages in books and all that. But I have not practiced to do it as a recitation. But I would like to have some thoughts about my poetic perspective, the sense. I'm not planning to give a lecture on poetry, but to me, poetry is something which makes others smile. Like, even if I am having pain within my body, my mind is always fresh, and my mind is always willing to make others feel happy. So when you scribble a quatrain, a couplet or a quatrain, you should have that thought in your mind. Your pain may not be the other person's pain. So when I am having pain, if I recite a poetry based on pain, that should give some impact to the other person. Avoid making that person to feel pain, but make that person happy by listening that poetry. This is my perspective, because poetry is always for blissfulness, happiness. And, you know, if I may be very sad, I may be having a lot of issues, problems, pain, and life may be a disaster. But when I meet a new person, there is no point in telling about your a disaster or your problem and make that person more painful. You know, so in other words, poetry should be always blissful, though we are having pain in our own mind. For example, I can quote a short a quatrain like, born with a drop of love within, born within a drop of love within, corn sprouts like a perishable bean. Cornflower, that is what I meant. Corn sprouts like a perishable bean. Babies live and smile at all in love. God is neither down nor up above. God is neither down nor up above. I did not prepare to recite this poem, but I just happened to have this thought in my mind. Hence, I just narrated this poem. I did not recite it, because I cannot claim that it is a recitation. It's just a narration only. And thank you for admitting me in this Zoom meeting. I will be waiting for some others to speak or recite poetry. And congratulations for organizing this event. Prasanna Kumar, am I right?
Yes, sir. We are known to each other, but we are not regularly meeting. But yes, thank you. It's such a honor for us.
Yeah. Basically, I am from Kerala, state of India. And I love to write poetry, preferably. And one of my novels is getting live day after tomorrow, on 1st November. It's a novel based on my thoughts about India's emergency period of 1976 to 77 duration, you know. So that is a thing, you know, because it's very difficult to write a novel. But for me, it is easier to write a poetry line or something. But novel normally takes 6 months to 6 years to complete the proper work. So I don't want to say much about myself, and this is not the right time. Thank you for listening to my few words. Prasanna Kumar, Prasanna K. Kumar, that's correct.
Prasanna Kumar, sir, no, not K, it's just, I just added, you know.
Yeah, that is to ensure the strength, you know, Kumar.
Yeah, exactly, that's, you caught the point.
yeah, because, you know, I was always wondering, is the spelling mistake. Prasanna means, the meaning in Malayalam, it is Prasanna means happy person, right? Happy.
Always calm.
And Kumar means you are the nurturing son. Kumar means a son, you know, very, very, you know, Kumaran.
You know, means, bachelor, you know, simply call me bachelor, yo.
Sorry?
I'm Kumar. Sorry? Bachelor.
Kumar, yeah.
Any bachelor.
Not yet married. So you are not yet married. That means you have to come a long way to learn poetry. You know, poetry will come your second wife or first wife.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Anderson. Thank you, ma'am. And let me jump on to the next poet who is, you know, came after a long time. I think I could call upon, she's a lovely poet, I would say. Her name is Lopamudra Mishra. Yeah.
Hello, I'm audible. Hello, audible. A happy poetic evening to all of you. As Maveli sir said, the poetry is to smile, and it's a smiling evening today. It's nice to meet you all, the great poetic luminaries, and the pleasure is mine. And it's always a wonderful experience to attain Prasanna ji's source. And I really long to attend, and it's everyone's fortunes. And now, so the bond that we share together is a special one, special bond. As soon as we see each other, we start smiling. And that's how our poetry begins. Poetry evolves. So the special bond we share with all of you is the name of my poem, Special Bond. This is a special bond, very powerful, stubble and strong, vigilant, active, and scintillating than other bond, probably. I long for it since long to seek the pleasure of its beauty, to get entrapped in its ingenuity, the ties of connectivity with the obligation to its authority. My heart beats, dance with gaiety. The power of bond triggers my creativity. I see, paint, sing, and paint with new artistry. My world smiles with its supremacy. I willingly follow the nuances of its activity. I pray for its longevity. This bond has changed my perspectives towards its charming individuality. Thank you, Krumat Prasanaji, for giving
me. All smiles with your beautiful rhythm and arriving intact. It's so wonderful, ma'am. Please keep coming.
Yeah,
thank you. On that note, let me call upon the next poet who is from Greece. Her name is Alexandra Psaropoulou. She's a well-known, artist, a graphic poet, I think. Alexandra.
Sorry, can you see the graphics, Kumar?
Perfect, ma'am, perfect.
Okay. Flying six. Golden cords connecting us, golden cords surrounding us. Like the sparkling sunlight on the blue sea, like the sparkling sun waves on the sea sand. Divine help, divine forces flowing in. Our vibrations riding over the waves of life, bravely crossing all barriers, singing a magnetizing melody on a hypnotizing journey, turning the dark into light, turning into right, knowing we can be free, knowing we are free, free from all negative energy, free from all negative experiences. Someone is singing along with me. Okay, golden cords connecting us, golden cords guiding us, like glowing strands intertwining along our paths, like glowing strands showing us our paths. Divine help, divine forces flowing in. Our vibrations, our energies, whirling, twirling. Wings of the universe dancing freely between us. Forming our world, forming the world around us. Turning the imbalanced into balanced. Turning the dark into light. Knowing we can be free. knowing we are free. Free from all lower sexual desires, free from all lower sexual encounters. Golden cords connecting us, golden cords attaching us. Like two radiant flames dancing together, like two radiant soul flames flying together. Divine help, divine forces flowing in. Our vibrations allowing us free to choose our own experiences, our own perceptions, allowing us free to move on, leaving old energies behind. Trusting that everything will be renewed, trusting that everything is being renewed. Turning the dark into light, turning the non-understandable into understandable. Knowing we can be free, knowing we are free. Free from all detrimental patterns, free from all detrimental beliefs. Golden cords connecting us, golden cords nurturing us. Like a family wonderfully bonding, like butterflies fluttering in spring. Divine help, divine forces flowing in. Our highest vibrations, our highest energies, whirling, twirling, drifting freely on the currents of the universe, transforming our world, transforming the worlds around us, turning the dark into light, turning the non-believing into believing, knowing we can be free, knowing we are free, free from all worry and struggle, free from all misconception and doubt, golden cords connecting us, golden cords uniting us, like the sacred heart flame, like the sacred soul flame. Divine help, divine forces flowing in. Our vibration strong and tender, taking us up our sweet magical worlds, strong and tender, taking us up our sweet blessed worlds. Knowing that our visions will come true, knowing that our visions are coming true. Turning the dark into light, turning the unhealthy into healthy. Knowing we can be healed, knowing we are healed. Healed from all bitterness and pain, healed from all hopelessness and regret. Only golden cords connecting us, only golden cords inspiring us. Expecting magic, expecting blessings, expecting flying. Thank you.
Wow. Alexandra, you always make us close eyes and listen to your, you know, utterance. You know, it takes such realms of silence. This is really wonderful. And thanks for presenting your lovely series of, you know, flying series. For us, you know, always.
Thank you. Thank I you. Think Hasmukh was singing a bit there in the beginning.
Hasmukh Mehta, yeah. Yeah. Just, you know, it's technical. Anyway, thank you for coming and thanks for presenting your flying series poem. Really, always. Now let me jump to India. And he's the one who is, running a magazine for the last 22 decades and he's been and it's been awarded by Sahitya Academy too, and that's the name of the magazine is Kavya Triveni. He's a wonderful poet as well. He's, you know, and I had the honor of, you know, my writing's been published in his magazine, and I thank him for coming to the platform and to recite his poem, and such an honor for us who are Veer Singh Marthand, his name. Thank you, sir. Thanks. Mic is yours.
Thank you. सबसे पहले मैं आप सभी लोगों को नमन करता हूं, विशेष करके प्रसन्ना जी को और मंच पर उपस्थित सभी कवियों को. मैं कोलकाता से हूं, जैसे आपने बता दिया, और मेरी मैगजीन है साहित्य त्रिवेणी, हिंदी, बंगला और उर्दू तीन भाषाओं की कविताओं को हम लोग प्रकाशित करते हैं. और मैं आपके सामने एक कविता प्रस्तुत कर रहा हूँ। लाइफ में सभी कुछ नेगेटिव नहीं होता, कुछ कुछ नेगेटिव चीजें अगर हम चाहें तो हमारे लिए पॉजिटिव होती हैं। हमारा देखने का एंगल ठीक होना चाहिए हमारा। तो इस कविता का शीर्षक हमने रखा है यदि, यदि को इंग्लिश में कहेंगे इफ। यदि यदि चुभना ही हो तो चुभो, मगर आलपिन की तरह। यदि चुभना ही हो तो चुभो, मगर आलपिन की तरह, जो चुभकर भी जोड़ जाती है दो पत्रों को। पत्र जिस पर अंकित हैं कुछ शब्द, शब्द जो ब्रह्म है। यदि जलना ही हो तो जलो, वरने यदि जलना ही हो तो जलो, मगर दीपक की तरह, जो जलकर भी देता है प्रकाश, प्रकाश जो तमस को भगाता है दूर, तमस जो प्रतीक है अज्ञान का, अज्ञान जो क्रोध का जनक है, क्रोध जो सभी बुराइयों की जड़ है। यदि गलना ही हो, मेल्ट होना, मेल्टिंग, यदि गलना ही हो तो गलो, मगर बर्फ की तरह, जो पिघल कर बनती है नदी, नदी जिसमें गति है, गति जो जीवन का दूसरा नाम है। यदि डूबना ही हो, यदि डूबना ही हो तो डूबो, मगर गोताखोर की तरह, जो सागर की अतलांत गहराइयों से खोज लाता है मोती, मोती जिसमें चमक है, चमक जो व्यक्तित्व का प्रतीक है। यदि ढलना ही हो तो ढलो, मगर सूरज की तरह, यदि ढलना ही हो तो ढलो, मगर सूरज की तरह, जो फिर उगता है नई सुबह के साथ, सुबह जो लाती है खुशियां, उत्साह एवं नई ऊर्जा, ऊर्जा जो जीवन के लिए आवश्यक है, ऊर्जा जो जीवन के लिए आवश्यक है। धन्यवाद।
बहुत खूब सर, बहुत खूब, ब्यूटीफुल मेटाफोरिक इमेजरी, वंडरफुल, थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग सर, थैंक यू, बहुत खूब। आई वुड लाइक टू नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू कॉल अपॉन रूपाली, डॉक्टर रूपाली सकर मैम टू यू नो से फ्यू वर्ड्स एंड रिसाइट हर पोएम। रूपाली मैम, माइक इज योर्स।
व्हाट कैन आई से अबाउट सच अ प्रोफाउंड पोएम, where he has, a poet has taken, and I'm saying it in English so that everybody can understand, that he has taken every little thing that happens. If a river, if you have to, you know, flow, then flow like a river. If you have to set down, then you set down like a sun, because next day there is a sunrise. So, you know, there is so much of sorrows and difficulties that we have to go through, but we have to go through it by raising ourselves from it. So thank you so much for this wonderful poem. Aapki kavita unke mein bahut prerit kiya hai. I'm going to read a poem which is a little funny, because it also, you know, happens to bring out the same kind of feeling, but in a little funny way. You know, we all have demons. हमारे अंदर एक राक्षस है, you know, we have some a demon that is always trying to come out, you know, and how is it that we deal with that demon? So the poem says dhanyavad. That...
Thank you, ma'am. Bahut bahut dhanyavad.
आप मुझे धन्यवाद दे रहे हैं, मुझे आपको देना चाहिए, आप कितनी बढ़िया कविता थी.
आपने इतनी अच्छी कविता की, इसके लिए आपको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू सो मच.
बहुत अच्छी समीक्षा की आप, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.
Now we have a, I'm going to read a poem, it's called Talking of Demons. You know, I do believe that poems should, one of our poets said, you know, I think that we must always be smiling. But I think Scott and Richard, they are protest poems. It protests, you know, unless you protest against racism, unless you protest in your literature of the things that have gone wrong, of history that has, you know, we can't progress. But this is a little cute poem. It says, talking of demons. I thought I had no demons, that I had laid them all to rest a very long time ago. Then the dark monsoon clouds, those cumulus nimbus ones came, threatening a subconscious chaos. Hurriedly, trying to close the door against the wind, a demon managed to slip in, green, scaly, with a demonic grin. It just settled in, crossing the scaly legs on the time-worn sofa. Looking around proprietorially, grinning all the time, at first shock, then annoyance at this intrusion, then the innate hospitality. Would you like some tea? I asked the demon. Nimbu pani or coffee, decaffeinated? That way, I thought slyly, he won't bounce off the walls. Caffeine does that to you, you know? He looked at me with one eye closed, with a rasping voice. He said, I am hungry. A cheese sandwich will do. Oh, it's a vegetarian fellow. Well, a sandwich and a tea later, he just picked up his scaly green body and slipped out, just as though big drops of rain began to fall. Well, that's all it needs to get rid of demons, kindness and understanding. So if you have kindness and understanding and you can share it, aapke andar jo bhi rakshas hai, wo chup-chap he will go away. So this is just a little funny poem, but it is also deeply felt. Thank you so much.
It's not a funny poem, it has, you know, message intact. That's a wonderful way of, you know, presenting a poem. It's a beautiful perspective. Wow, wonderful, ma'am. What a beautiful.
Thank you so much, Prasanna.
I think I could go on that note to a young poet. I think she would Sophia and react on that. I would like to react on your poem and then go on reading her poem. Her name is Dr. Gargi Saha.
Thank you, sir. Ma'am's poem was wonderful. It has so much of humor. Am I audible, sir? Am I audible?
Perfect.
Okay. It was a lovely poem, ma'am, with so much of humor. You cannot even think of demons, you know, and you're inviting them with food, categorizing them among vegetarian, non-vegetarian. It was a lovely poem.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. And thank you, Prasanna sir, for inviting me in this platform of esteemed luminaries from all over the world. Today, I would like to read my poem, Words. Look, how to do things with words. Words can heal, words can kill, words can build rapport, words can destroy relations, words can join two souls, words can divorce, words can bless, words can curse, words can appoint, annoy, annihilate, words can bother, blame, baptize. Look at the power of words, how to do things with words, those tiny alphabets sitting in the books, staring with the books closed. Oh, how I wonder how they relax restlessly, passively powerful. So the pen is mightier than the sword, for they spill words. Words form sentences. Sentences builds para, discourse, and languages. How to use language at one's own discretion, to sing hymns, prayers, or abuse someone. Thank you.
Beautiful, ma'am. Beautiful, wonderfully written. I mean, it's beautifully, words. You said about words and, you know, sentences and how the, you know, weaving happens. Wonderful, beautifully presented. And now I think we have pretty much young first timers with us, you know, on Twitter Lens today evening.
One of my questions is
Akka. I don't know her full name, but yes, Mo Poetry Phillips. Welcome, Mo.
Thank you so much. Welcome, everyone. And sorry I'm late. Such an extreme time difference. It's 10:19 here, so I was not expecting. Okay. I'll just read a short little story from my book, which is Equals Greatness. It's out on Amazon. It's Come Back Up. I didn't want to be a stereotypical Black girl who couldn't swim. I remember getting my mom's permission to take swimming lessons at the Boys and Girls Club downtown. I was eager to show off my new bathing suit that day. I remember the male instructor, tall and slender. He must have been very tall because somehow the description of what his face looked like got lost in the clouds while everything else deep, voice, chest covered with a t-shirt, red and blue swimming trunks, and white gym shoes are vividly remembered. As he pulled off his gym shoes, he directed all of us aged 10 to 16 to line up in order of birth months. We all scrambled around shouting, November, February, June, May, pushing each other aside, pulling each other forward until we were in month order. I was one of the last ones to be placed in line because as soon as he said month order, my birth month, March, caused me to feel paralyzed. Now jump off the diving board into the 12 foot was the only instructions he spoke. My mind totally blacked out. I didn't remember the other children going in or coming to the top. I don't remember any sounds of children talking, playing, or cheering. The only thing I remember is feeling water rush past me on my left and right as my hands were spread open wide. I sank to the bottom at lightning speeds, where I sat there Indian style, jaws full of air, heart full of fear, knowing soon the air would be gone and I'd have to take a mouthful of water. The instructor must have finally realized I was buried underneath those 12 feet of water a bit too long and decided he had to jump in and rescue me. When he reached the top, he scolded. Why didn't you come back up to the top? You were supposed to push off the bottom, swim towards the light, and come back up. Funny thing is, where were those instructions before I jumped off the diving board? Somehow that experience seemed symbolic of my life. My need to try things out of the desire not to fit into various stereotypes. The harsh reality that more than likely, I have to jump right in, sink to the bottom, be scolded for not knowing what to do, even though all the valuable information to help me rise to the top will be excluded. Push off the bottom, swim towards the light, and come back up. Thank you.
Wow, wonderful. Mo, thanks for making it tonight on Fertile Grains this morning for you. And I would, on that note, I think the best person who would be, you know, saying, you know, indirect, to react on your words would be the one who is staying right now is at your place is Padmavati ma'am. Yeah, that is perfect. Yeah, I think Padmavati ma'am.
Hi, Prasanna. Yeah, I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, good ma'am. Yeah, you could say a few words about most you know occurring, and you could read your poem before my calling on the next poet. So you go. Go ahead, ma'am.
Yeah. It was really a wonderful poem. What I felt was it's like, you know, nostalgic, like started remembering so many things and her lifestyle and her desires, discipline, so many things like that. Am I right, ma'am?
Yes, thank you so much. Yes.
Yeah, it was wonderful. Mo, and your rendition was really good. I really enjoyed. You know, like you had a nostalgia, right? Yeah, it was nice. It was really a very good poem, ma'am.
Thank you.
Keep coming, Amol.
Definitely. I appreciate the invitation. I definitely will.
Thank you. Ma'am.
Yeah, can I recite, Prasanna?
Yes, ma'am, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm reciting a small poem. Hello, everyone. Good evening to all. Namaste, good morning, whatever it is. Yeah. The title of my poem is Home. A feeling of oneness, a feeling of belonging, a thought of livelihood and sharing pain and joy under the sun. Home is not a family, it's a feeling. A place of diverse folks where they quarrel, connect and unite. It's a feeling of love, ego and friendliness. Home is not a family, it's a feeling. Walls of a building aren't a home. Alter it to a home with warmth. Dutiful members make it a home filled with bliss and peace. In turn, label it as a heaven. Home is not a family, it's a feeling. Thank you.
Exactly, ma'am. It's a feeling, it's an emotion, it's everything, you know, home. Lovely to be home. We have everything. No, thank you, ma'am. Thank you. That's a beautiful rendition too. I mean, beautifully you recited. That's so slow. I mean,
thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Very pleasant. I will say very pleasant.
Thanks a lot. Your words mean a lot to me, Prasanna.
Thank you, ma'am. Now let me call upon our first timer on Fatal Vance, a lovely Balikasen Gupta. Please turn on your mic, ma'am.
Namaste. Hello.
Namaste, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Hello.
Namaste. Good evening.
Good evening, ma'am. Main
Lucknow se aap sabho ke sabak chhu. Aaj aur kaafi prasannata ki anubhav kar rahi hu ki mujhe yahan invite kiya gaya hai. और मैं आज आप लोगों को अपनी कविता सुनाने जा रही हूं जिसका शीर्षक है आत्माहुति. और ये कविता मेरी प्रकाशित हो चुकी है आतिश तू में, और उसपे फौकिया वाजिद जी के साथ और जावेद अख्तर जी के साथ, कौसर मुनीर जी के साथ. मैं भाग्यशाली मानती हूँ, खुद को सौभाग्यशाली मानती हूँ कि मैं इसमें हूं. तो आइए दोस्तों, आत्मा होती. रेत की पतली चादर स्पष्ट पदचिन्ह, रेत की पतली चादर स्पष्ट पदचिन्ह, बारीक भूत वर्तमान और भविष्य. यात्रा अनवरत सागर तट, कदम बढ़ाता चला यात्री सतत, कदम बढ़ाता चला यात्री सतत, लम्हा लम्हा कर्म काल क्रम, काल चक्र की परछाई, काल चक्र की परछाई, लो संतुलन की घड़ी आई. कहीं टीले समतल या गहरी खाई, कहीं टीले समतल या गहरी खाई, या सागर संग चलती डाले गलबहिया, चलती डाले गलबहिया, कोई रेतीली नदी मुस्काई, समुद्र तल पर जाकर फैलकर हो गई स्थिर, गहरे पानी की पैठ पाना जो सच्चा मोती, न गवा समय न व्यर्थ बैठ, न गवा समय न व्यर्थ बैठ, नदी की स्रोत तले समय की बहती जो धारा, कहाँ भटका फिरता तू रे बंजारा, हो दिशाहारा. सदियों की गवाही देते पलों में होकर अनंत मौन और स्थिर सदियों की गवाही देते पलों में होकर अनंत मौन और स्थिर चल रहा राही पुनः पुनः फिर फिर पुनः पुनः फिर फिर चाहे क्यों ना आए सौ बार मुश्किलों के बादल घोर घनघोर घिर घिर देखना देखना संभलना ना घबराना देखना देखना संभलना ना घबराना ए राही चोटों ठोकरों के बच्चों हो चोटिल न जाना तुम गिर बाधाओं के क्षितिज की सीमाहीन सिलवटों किसी भी मुमकिन नामुमकिन बंधनों से मुक्त हो पड़े अस्तित्व के नसों में आत्म सम्मान आत्मविश्वास का लहू बारंबार दौड़ाना आत्म सम्मान आत्मविश्वास का लहू बारंबार दौड़ाना देखना देखना ना ठिठक जाना कहीं चौराहे तिराहे दौराहे पर जीवन की पंचवटी पर ओज तेज से प्रतापित सूरज को देना होने उदित उद्दीप्त चल नए सफर पर हो निर्माण चित्त निर्भीक निर्भय निडर करे प्रज्वलित आत्मदीपक राह प्रशस्त करे खुद की औरों की हो निवेदन हो आवेदन सौम्य स्नेह युक्त रूहानी मिलन आत्मालिंगन चलो चले हे वीर चलो चले हो प्रचंड प्रखर प्रवीण प्रवीर आज सुनो ध्यान से देना होगा आत्माहुति देना होगा आत्माहुति पुकार गूंजती प्रतिध्वनित चहुओर पुकार गूंजती प्रतिध्वनित चहुओर अहो चहु दिशाएं तुम्हारे ही इंतजार में अहो चहु दिशाएं तुम्हारे ही इंतजार मुझे पूरी उम्मीद है कि आप सबको मेरी कविताएं अच्छी लगी होंगी और अगर आप लोग और कविताएं मेरी सुनना चाहते हैं आप लोग मेरी कविताएं और सुनना चाहते हैं
फिलहाल तो नहीं मैम आई थिंक वी हैव लाइन ऑफ पोएट्स सो बहुत गहरे सो बहुत गहराई है आपकी कविताओं में बहुत खुश नसीब है हम तो आपको सुने जो सुना आई थिंक द नेक्स्ट वन आई थिंक हु द बेस्ट वन या धन्यवाद Thank you for coming and really amazing poem, very deep and deep and profound. And thanks for presenting your poem. I think I would the best one who would now. I think Hasmukh Mehta. Yeah, Hasmukh Mehta sir would be the best one to react on your poem, and he said his poem as well.
Hello, good evening, sir. Good evening, sir. Shubh Sandhya ki kamna. और मैंने इतने गौर से सबको सुना मुझे पाई से आप भी सुनेंगे और थोड़ी हौसला अफजाई करेंगे तो मैं दो पोएम के साथ मैं आगे बढ़ना चाहूँगा मेरा खुद का कंठस्थ उसको दूंगा तो आप एंजॉय कीजिए मैं शुरू करने जा रहा हूँ सोचता है कुछ और करता है कुछ मैं इसका कंठ भी देने जा रहा हूं मिली है सौगंध कृपा से तू आया है इस जगत मेहरबानी से भाकर ऐसी हैरानी जिस हो जाए दोजक जवानी सोचता है कुछ ना होगा कुछ फिर सोचने से ना मिट जाएगा तेरे कहने से जो होगा वही होगा उसके करने से बंद कर चेतानी दूसरों से तू सोचता है तू सोचता है कुछ और करता है कुछ ना है बस मैं तेरे अच्छा करना सिर्फ दिखाता रहे तू गुस्सा अपना तू सोचता है कुछ तू सोचता है अपने बारे में झूठ बोलता है अपनों के बारे में नाक नादानी और खेल जिंदगानी खत्म हो जाएगी ये जिंदगी पानी ना कर दू यदि करना चाहता है कुछ जीवन में नहीं जाना है तूने कोई वन में जो है वो इसी तरह ताल पर है ईमान तेरा सबसे ऊपर है तू सोचता है ना मंदिर ना मस्जिद ना कोई चर्च मन की शांति को ना कर तू खर्च ढूंढ तू अपने में खुदा बन जाएगा तू समंदर का ना खुदा सबसे बड़ा एक ही है इंसान खुदा तेरे मत तेरे पर बरसेगी खुशियां बिखेरेगी जन्नत ले जाएगी तू सोचता है कुछ प्रेम की दुहाई सबको देता जा दुआई के बदले में प्यार लेता जा संसार का नियम यही है जो जाता है उसे आना नहीं है इसी के साथ मेरी हिंदी कविता समाप्त हुई हो सकता है आपको थोड़ा सा मजा आया होगा तो आप इजाजत दे तो मैं इंग्लिश की पोएट करना चाहूंगा सर आप
प्लीज गो अहेड प्लीज गो अहेड
ओके सर सो I have written about love, leave, and belief. And I have expanded it with my imagination, you know. So, love is a line of various emotions. For live intelligently and value emotions. And believe, I have said, brave enough, lead independently, echo vibes eternally. That is belief. So, one has to stop thinking and live. Love has ruled and not fooled. It has remained a powerful tool and everybody has remained successful. If love finds no response, everybody becomes tense. There is a disaster signal and cause sufferance for all the individuals. Love has a space for the human race. In case they practice hatred, their life shall be led in oblivion. Never underestimate the power of love and pretend not to believe. It has its own sanction to build the relation. Human life has a poverty and suffering the misery but we care for the humanity. And this is how grace comes from an Almighty. Think never and live with the fears. Life shall make you bear, but ultimately shower with the success. Love has little touch of bitterness, but always provides sweetness. Make an earnest effort for its trace. Love shall always put a smile on the face. Love has removed the cruelty, brought in wonderful changes, and removed faulty thinking, developed sense of belonging, and pursued no more wronging. Now with this, I end my poet with love to you all. Thank you very much.
Love is all. Wonderful, sir. Thanks for your beautiful singing and beautiful poem. You always, you know, amaze me with your, you know, you always inspire me. You know, at this age, you are continuously right. Oh my God, what an energy. I mean, thank you, sir. Keep us inspiring always and keep coming. And on that note, I think I could go ask Lucille. Who is away after, who came after a long time, and welcome, Lucille. Mike is yours. You could say some words and you could recite your poem.
Hi, it's great being back. And I want to say something about the chanting. I want to say that the power of the singing, of the chanting, of is almost like a mantra singing. Arrives directly, even if you don't understand any word. It was really beautiful. Thank you so much, Asmo. And now my poem, it's originally in Italian, but I will read only in English with my translation. Today is a perfect day. I haven't died since the full moon. You haven't killed me. 90 and 10 hours plus a handful of minutes. I lost the count of the seconds, but I'm still counting. There is a divine principle in trusting and surrendering, to go beyond the corner of the self, to offer world and sky nights without sleep, to render infinite each word. Somewhere, someone is dying. I saw it on TV, a paper bomb, a tank armed with insult, a boat without oars, without beaches to arrive to, a name ripped braid by braid. He's holding red poppy panties. One by one, the lights go out on the streets. The night gives way to light. And I have not died since the full moon. Thank you.
Wow. Wonderful, Lucille. As always, your poet, cold to heart, you know, I would say. Wonderful. Thanks for, you know, your contribution towards literature and your work that is in for translation or in your mother tongue or in English, whatever. It's wonderful, amazing, always, you know. Thank you. And let's go to the next poet. Yes, that place is known for, you know, annual celebration of Durga Puja and with a pomp and grandeur, and you know, this is very much known world across. It's a beautiful place called Mysore. Prabhashastri, she's a motherly figure to me, and I welcome Prabhashastri Ma to recite a poem in Telugu. Yeah. Please turn on your mic.
Good evening to all my fertile brain friends. My name is Prabhashastri. I am from Mysore. Today, first I am telling one small English poem. Then I will tell in Telugu, my mother tongue. Okay? Some things are not to be tested. Some things are not to be tested. Things that cause pain are to be ignored. Not to think of unnecessary details, not to think of unnecessary details. Yes, necessary ones. Not to invite tears or cry during moments of pleasure. Let no sorrow or pain come to between moments of joy or happiness. Let us lead day to day life with hope and not despair. Namaskar. Now I am telling one Telugu poem written by me. That is little bit sorrow, but I like that poem. Okay. Kavi Kanniru. Poem name is Kavi Kanniru. Nuvoka Rangula Tummedavu. Nuvoka Rangula Tummedavu. Sita Koka Chilukla Singarinchukoni. Sita Koka Chilukla Singarinchukoni. నా కనులలో కనుపాప బొమ్మవైనావు. నా కనులలో కనుపాప బొమ్మవైనావు. నిదురించిన శృంగార చిలిపి చేష్టలు లేపావు. నిదురించిన శృంగార చిలిపి చేష్టలు లేపావు. నీ పక్కకు దృష్టి తిప్పి రంగుల పొంగులైన నా మదిని, రంగుల పొంగులైన నా మదిని ముక్కలగా నరికి నరికి విసిరి తుర్రుమన్నావు. ముక్కలుగా నరికి నరికి విసిరి తుర్రుమన్నావు. నీకోసం కట్టిన చుక్కల పల్లకి పోసిపోయింది. నీకోసం కట్టిన చుక్కల పల్లకి పోసిపోయింది. బాపూబొమ్మవైన నువ్వు నల్లని బండరాయి అయినావు. నల్లని బండరాయి అయినావు. జీవనదిగా ప్రవహించు జీవితాన్ని ఎండమావైనది. కలల ముత్యాలహారం కళ్ళలై కంఠం మౌనమయ్యింది. ఇలా ఎందుకు ఎడారి బ్రతుకు చేశావు? మతిపోయిన మరువలేనిది ఈ బాధ. గుండెలను పిండి అపహాస్యం చేసే భవిష్యత్తు. కలల్లో ఇంకు ఇంకి ప్రేమలెక్కలతో గడ్డ కట్టింది. కలల్లో ఇంకు ఇంకి ప్రేమలేఖలతో గడ్డ కట్టింది. ఇక నీకోసం నీ ప్రేమ కావ్యాలు రాయలేను. ఉంటాను మరి మరో జన్మ ఉంటే కలుద్దాం. థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ ప్రసన్న.
Mind blowing, ma'am. I think Setaluri, Padma ma'am would have understood this thing. I think she would be the perfect one who could, you know, comment on that. Yeah, but it's in the gist, I would say this for all the poets who are, you know, listening to the Prabhasastry ma'am poem is all about a poet and for the poet and by the poet, the tears of a poet. Now, Padmavati ma'am.
Yeah. Hello everyone. Prabha ma'am, it was really good. Chala bondi, bhavayuktanga undi, tarvata meeru recitation chesina vidhanam kuda chala bondi feelings toti. మంచి వర్డ్స్ సెలెక్ట్ చేసుకున్నారు. నెగటివిటీని చెప్తూనే పాజిటివిటీని చెప్పారు మీరు. సో దాట్ ఈస్ యునో బ్యూటీ ఆఫ్ ద పోమ్. యాక్చువల్లీ ప్రభా మ్యామ్ వాజ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్ అబౌట్ హర్ డ్రీమ్. మేబీ షీ వాంట్స్ టు మీట్ అ సమ్వన్, ఐ మీన్ ద పోయెట్ లవ్స్ ఆర్ లైక్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్. షీ వాజ్ జస్ట్ ఇమాజినింగ్ very good things about her life, but at the same time, she was feeling sad as she did not get whatever she wanted to get. That is what it was. That is all about love, affection, longingness. I can say that, you know, she was longing for something. Am I correct, ma'am?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. That is what she was just expressing her love towards a person. And she was just, you know, describing her dreams. And in dreams, whatever she was imagining and feeling, I can say, you know, when we imagine something through our dreams, I think we also feel that, you know, we are, what I want to say, we are experiencing it. You know, she was just explaining those experiences that she was, you know, having through her dreams. And she also expressed where she was feeling a negative thought, you know, though there is some positivity, she was trying to feel negative often. Am I right, ma'am? Prabhagaru, correct chepana?
Yes, yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, okay, ma'am. Prasanna, I think I am clear.
I think this is what is needed, man. Instead, you know, this is not at all about reciting or something like, you know, reading out poetry and laying out the grow, you know. It's not like that, you know, just pondering over the poem that has been recited and, you know, go into the deep, you know, essence of the thing and giving a feedback.
Yeah. There is a depth in meaning, first thing.
Exactly.
At the same time, there is a lesson one could learn through her poem. At the same time, yes, I think indirectly she suggested to be positive.
Exactly. And this also gives the other poets an inspiration. I mean, it's like an cue to write on, deliberate on something and to take good write on something. On that note, I think, thank you, ma'am. On that note, I think Acharya is here with us. I don't know how he understands. I just always wonder, you know, I'm at wit's end. You know, he always understands that even in we recite in a Telugu language or Bengali language, in Hindi language. I don't know. I would like to ask our Acharya, Kingsley. Lantern carrier.
That's the stage when you give yourself to the divine, the whole universe works with you. So I pick up on things.
Correct. I have no words to say. I think.
Yeah.
Were you calling me to perform?
Let me get back to you in a while.
Sure.
Yeah. Thank you, Prema ma'am. Thank you, Landon Carrier. Thank you, Prabhasastri Amma, for, you know, presenting your beautiful poem, both in English and in Telugu as well. Now, let me call upon the folk singer, songwriter. He calls himself a wonderful, you know, English writer. He writes in beautiful lyrics too in English. And, you know, and it's like, I mean, he always smiles in the loving personality. His name is Murali Renukuntala.
Sir, good evening all.
Good evening, sir.
Is it audible, sir?
Yeah, perfect, sir.
Namaste. Andriki namaskar. Sir, I would like to recite my poem in English. Later, if you give me chance, a song written by me in Telugu. Just before, when I was traveling, I went, sir. Shadow. And the shadow. I am the shadow. I wake up along with you in the morning. I wake up along with you in the morning with the birds chirping, the sun rising. And I go to bed in the night along with you. And I go to bed the night along with you. The sun sets in the evening. The sun sets in the evening. I hope to you, I'm big or small, I'm not there at all. I hope to you, I'm big or small, I'm not there at all, because I move from here and there. I move from here and there. I'm so silent, I can walk and run on the earth and water faster than you. I'm so silent, I can walk and run on the earth and water faster than you. I can dominate the light but the me in the dark nights. I can dominate in the light, but the me in the dark nights. I wander all meadows, the garden among the lovers and people. I wander all meadows, the garden among the lovers and the people. Everyone can enjoy the beauty in me by seeing me when there is no mirror, and there is no mirror. Haven't color, haven't crooked teeth, haven't strange eyes. There's no distinction to me, but all are equal to me, but all are equal to me. I am neither tall, large, I am neither large nor thin. Nothing can harm me. Nobody can defeat me. I can conquer the world. I can conquer the world. There is a story about me. There is a story about me. Once the lion looked into the well. Once the lion looked into the well, began roaring by seeing me. As if there is another lion, as envy. It fell in the well and died. Fell in the well and died. I am the shadow. I am the shadow. I never die. I never die. I remain forever. I remain forever until the nature is there. So this is the poem, yes, sir.
Wonderful,
thank you.
Sir. Wonderful, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for coming. Sir, I think we are running.
Nigamyani cheruko. పోరాటం లేకుండా ప్రగతి లేదురా పోరాటం లేకుండా ప్రగతి లేదురా ప్రగతి లేకుండా ప్రగతి లేదురా ఓ యువత మేలుకో ఉన్నత లక్ష్యాన్ని ఎన్నుకో నీ గమ్యాన్ని చేరుకో ఆటుపోట్లు లేకుండా తుఫానే లేదురా ఆటుపోట్లు లేకుండా తుఫానే లేదురా ఆందోళన లేకుండే స్వాతంత్రము లేదురా ఓ యువత మేలుతో ఉన్నత లక్ష్యాలయంతో నీ గమ్యాన్ని చేరుతో నేల దున్నకుండా పంటలే లేవురా నేల దున్నకుండా పంటలే లేవురా కష్టపడకుండా సుఖాలే లేవురా ఓ యువత మేలుతో ఉన్నత లక్ష్యాన్ని ఎందుకో నీ గమ్యాన్ని చేరుకో ఉరుములే లేకుండా మెరుపులే రావురా ఉరుములే లేకుండా మెరుపులు రావురా మెరుపులు లేకుండా వర్షమే కురవదురా ఓ యువత మేలుతో ఉన్నత లక్ష్యాన్ని ఎందుకో కిరటాల గర్జన లేకుండా సముద్రమే ఉండదురా పరాజయము లేనిదే విజయమే లేదురా ఓ యువత మేలుతో ఉన్నత లక్ష్యాన్ని ఎందుకో నీ గమ్యాన్ని చేరుకో ఆటంకాలు ఎన్ని ఉన్నా ప్రతికూలతలు ఎన్ని ఉన్నా ఆటంకాలు ఎన్నో ఉన్నా ప్రతికూలతలు ఎన్నో ఉన్నా లక్ష్యం మరువకురా గమ్యం చేరే వరకు సాధన ఆపకురా గమ్యం చేరే వరకు ఓ యువత మేలుకో ఓ యువత మేలుకో ఓ యువత మేలుకో థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ సార్
థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్ థ్యాంక్ యూ
Thank you, sir. Thank you for presenting a motivational, inspirational poem for youth. Rise and rise and rise. Thank you. And now let me call upon
Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you.
You are such a jovial character, and every character represents some sort of unique perspective. You are one of them. Thank you.
Please recite your poem, sir. Thank you.
Yes. But before I recite my poem, I want to say a few words. Reciting is one thing, and its interpretation takes different forms. And while interpreting a poem, critic can take the poem or discuss the poem from any perspective. See, Keats wrote Ode to a Nightingale, but as a critic, I doubt whether he heard or listened to the music of Nightingale. But it is the critic who takes any form. And in one of the groups, I commented on one of the poems of a new poet. And he said, sir, I did not mean that. I told him, interpretation of poem does not mean that I should interpret what the poet thought and said. A critic can take the poem anywhere. There is no boundary like blood. So now, I must read out a poem. Recently, we had been on tour in Andaman, and there was a cyclone alert, and people residing there very much aware of its premonitions. And we cooked up in a hotel room. So we are supposed to go another island from Swarajdeep, means Havelock Island. Ferry was stranded, people cooped up in the hotels. We headed towards the key, ferry. Then we came to know it has been cancelled. Government did not apprise us because it was the natural calamity. So we retreated to our lodge, and after 2 days, and ferry started, and we moved towards the Neil Island. And I had tried to write my feelings as a waiting. Waiting is painful, and sometimes waiting yields fruit also. So the title of the poem is Waiting. We all were decidedly put on ropes. The Nautica was destined at 9 a.m. and packed up the tidbit of quarters. The cab was all on toast to run down. Just before the quay, we breezed in the government franchisee to know the news. The cancellation was not apprised us. However, we retreated to the Dolphin. This was not the sun lounge, a counter. The feathered cushion seemed to have the craig of the Indian Ocean at Swarajdeep, the deceptive dash with the surf towed under the feet, and undercurrent pulled us like the irresponsible curiosity for the Neil Island. As ill luck would have it, we grieved alone. The sofa of Indian look retouched the alien. Thank you very much.
It's the experience of waiting. Yes, sir. Sometimes I think, what could I say? Then thank you for coming, and thank you for presenting your poem and your, you know, your view on, you know, critics, criticism, and critic, being a critic on the, you know, thing. Thank you, sir. You are always, you know, a guiding force for the fertile brains. You always give prompts.
You are the man, you know, piercing through all odds and all. Hats off to you for your patience and all. Because, holding this thing does not, come easily, but organizing, coordinating needs tremendous endeavor. I salute that endeavor you are put in.
With all your support, sir, with all your support and, encouragement. Moving on, thank you for moving on. Now, I would like to call upon our very lively poet, Gangalaxmi Patnaik, who is going to present us, present your poem for what? Halloween.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. It's a great pleasure to receive invitation from Kumar Prasanna to attend the poem reading program online. I am extremely impressed with the recital program esteemed poet Prasanna Kumar is organizing on every Sunday. Before recitation, I just present theme of Halloween as it's commonly referred a global celebration on October 31st. In the simplest terms, it's a festival celebrating the changing seasons from light to dark, that is summer to winter. It's a time when people dress up in costumes. Ghosts and witches are popular costumes of the children who go from house to house saying trick or treat. The treat is usually candy and chocolates, but Prasanna has not given us any chocolates here. Okay, now I am reciting the poem. Now I would like to present the poem. The title is Hello, Halloween. Halloween is the beautiful theme of the simple poem's being. Halloween is the beautiful theme of the simple poem's being. Ghostly greetings sprinkled with care and wear in happy haunting. Ghostly greetings sprinkled with care and wear in happy haunting. It is the end of summer, the beginning of chill bitter. It is the end of summer, the beginning of chilly bitter. Build bonfires to mark change of seasons at the door. Build bonfires to mark change of seasons at the door. Halloween, a real treat. Celebrate dead and fantastic night. Halloween, a real treat. Celebrate dead and fantastic night. If you want tasty sweet, to be sure to give treat. If you want tasty sweet, to be sure to give treat. Have a spook. Spectacular, attractive, beautiful, wonderful, and fantastic Halloween. Have a spook. Spectacular, attractive, beautiful, wonderful, and fantastic Halloween. Wishing a night full of frights and delights flowing within. Wishing a night full of fright and delights glowing within. Today is day to eat candies to heart's content. Happy Halloween. Today is day to eat candies to heart's content. Happy Halloween. Dead rise, birds fly, terror strikes, screams, tonight it is Halloween. Dead rise, birds fly, terror strikes, screams, tonight it is Halloween. Now my presentation is over and thanks everybody for patient hearing. Special thanks to esteemed poet founder, Fertile Brains, K. Kumar Prasanna. Thanks. Thank you. Sound asleep? Sound. Oh, the sound asleep.
Sorry, I was turned on. I turned off the mic. He always present us lovely chocolates. Today it was, Halloween poem, and so beautifully presented, and you explained it in your voice.
He has not presented candies today to us.
No,
it is good. Candies. Today is the candy day, Halloween.
Yeah, but then you presented. Yeah, thank you for presenting. Yes, thank you. Thanks for coming. thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Now I'd like to call upon she came after a long time and she has her proof and mirror
poetic mirror, Bharati Hazarika, ma'am.
Okay. Good morning, good afternoon to everyone. I enjoyed the poems, Telugu, Tamil, and other English poems, and loved it. Hello, am I audible?
Perfect, ma'am. Perfect, perfect.
Yes, yes. Okay. Now, I want to read my poem. That is Silong Peak. Let's go with me to the Silong Peak. Silong Peak. The pines have gone down line by line. The pines have gone down line by line. Houses have gone up and down. The roads are going up and down zigzaggedly. The pines are swaying, spoke in a whisper, calling with each outstretched hand and hugging each other. The gentle sunshine came and sat on my back. The wind that blows, splitting my hair. The clouds came with great speed, suddenly from where, with a rhythm of rimjin. A song of rain came down. After the end of a whistling sound, the clouds fled. That old game of sun and wind, the sun came out with a sweet smile. Do you remember that afternoon at the Silong Peak, you and me? Thank you.
Now I would like to give a brief charge to to Roopali, ma'am. I'll come back.
So I can call upon, this is a wonderful poem you've read, Bharati. It was, in fact, adding to the mellifluous evening. So I can call upon Dr. Molly Joseph, who's a brilliant poet, and she's renowned all over the world. And I read her poems in so many forums and hear her. So Molly, let's hear about, what you have to say today in very, your Kerala and your land and your coconuts and everything.
So sweet of you, Roopali ji, for giving the sweet introduction to me. Yes, Halloween happens in one part of the world. Here in my part of rural Kerala, especially in my parish, we call it parish in my village, Mother Mary festival is going on in full swing. Trumpets, hymns, chants, processions. I hope my voice is clear enough. Is it?
Yes, yes. Very clear.
So I just want to, get back from, I was just quoting from there. And Bharati, you went around the whole thing, so picturesque through the memory lane. I loved it. So here I am also taking you to the memory lane concerning the kind of faith that keeps us on life. See? Actually, what is the basic thing that draws us to places like this? Essentially, man's own feel like this. Beyond fears and hates, life slips away, sweeping shores. The rest of the journey, after a star, that will not play fault. A compass that will not lie. Though the thunder reverberates over the mountains, it dies away over the oceans. Winter is the valley beyond our fears and hates. Yes, we search for it in the church, in the temple, in the mosque. Seeking that harbor, the anchor of faith. So here it goes again, my poem. Church, while prayers from church filled up the air, thick with rumbling pressure of compulsion, yearnings, thanksgiving, memories went aglow of the dear departed, sleeping in silence in adjacent churchyard. The leaves nodding heads over the graves, the grass surrounding the tombs in reveries. Prayers float, roiling memories sedimented. Are they listening, the dead, or moving in the wind through the knowing leaves and grass joining? On time's flickering edge, when life pitters out, the same 6 feet, the same locale awaits me, my vagrant, voyaging self. Can it sense and see the roll repeated as whispers resonate on shores of future, making their way high, swish past the meadows of my eternal rest? The thoughts I had while I was in church, I'm sharing with you. Thank you, dear Prasanna, for accommodating me, Roopali ji, for inviting me.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Molly. Memories and remembering the dead, we're all here for a very short while. And we not only celebrate life, but I think we had Dr. Gangalaxmi talking about Halloween. I remember when I was a young person, I had gone, jumped over a wall and collected some, stuff from a graveyard and brought it for Halloween. And my mother was so angry, she almost threw me out of the house. But memories, poems are made out of memories. There's so much that we write. And I think Bharati also, is there anybody who would like to say a few words about Dr. Molly Joseph's poem? You're most welcome. How about Lantern Carrier?
Well, I love Dr. Molly's poetry and her particular diction, the way she enunciates a sense of delivery and emphasis and the engaging and impactful way that she recites. I love that too, very much.
Thank you, Lantern. Thank you so
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Prasanna is back.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for, taking up the charge for in it very well. That's a wonderful thing. I mean, that's a lot. And thank you for the honor, ma'am. Roopali, ma'am. You understand me always. Okay, now I think I could, take the charge. I am ready. Thank you, ma'am, Roopali. Thank you, Molly Joseph. My yes, diction. You always never miss here. Wonderful. Lantern.
That is a beautiful poem. Very beautiful.
Exactly. Now, up next, we have Lantern and Tanya, Jennifer, and Durgachari will be written. So,
thank you. Enthralled by beauty, my lips cascade verses on the rose pink of autumnal leaves, even as my breath whispers to the wafts of purple lavenders. My heart, so fond of rainbows, murmurs like soaring butterflies bathed in the pageantry of sunsets and horizons. Whenever your radiance invigorates the sunflowers, I feel a surrender compelling me to cup my hands, a deep profundity and reverence that bewilders me. The full moon swallows the night, the stars convey mystic smiles to the cheeks of my immaculate queen. I love the naivety of children. There's much innocence in the prance and charms that charms the heart, a soft sweetness in the giggles, an enduring spontaneity that thrills my soul. I love the gaiety and laughter, cute children playing, the way they frolic and clap their hands, dynamic yet charming like a rose. Sometimes I sit in stillness, bewitched by the lapis lazuli of an azure blue vastness, not due to the perennial heavens, but a comforting indigo that draws me like a devoted magnet to the sweet gaze of my beloved. O light, O heaven, you have dipped my core in a kaleidoscope of emotions, only to feed the agony of my longing for the hue of thy love. Poem 2. I seem to have lost it. Give me a issac. Oh. Looks like I just found it. Love is an accomplished weaver. Me, a tiny thread still been woven together by this supreme artist. The nightingale symphony of my lyrical songs have not yet blossomed. The inner passions like a flame consumed me in darkness. Yet you watch over me like the heavens splitting the night sky with golden beams of heavenly light. So dark were the caverns that I entered, so many tears shed in my despair. When the painful past appeared, it not only clouded my memories, but made my heart bleed. Now I water your love like flowers, so they grow well and use the gift of speech without speaking. Your quintessence lies in the silent whispers of the soul, but the light of thy consuming fire blessed my poor sight. My grief was born in pain and loneliness. Scrolls of blood flowed and colored my joy. Old memories fade eventually like breath. Now your effulgence dazzles like the sun. Camouflage within desire, my hope flies a majestic butterfly unspooling a silk cocoon in search of the beloved. My inner flares light up the nights like shooting stars. When dawn awakes, I see the sun and moon sharing a kiss together on the sacred blue shafts of infinitude. I become a lover, seeking the one responsible for such magical formations. On the wings of my dreams lies the bewilderment of our tomorrows. Our smiles blend with its steadfast gaze, bemused by the intricacies of luminous supernovae. My heart hears melodies in stillness, 1,000 times more beautiful than the harp of minstrels. My soul now twirls, putting the dance of a million stars to shame. No more eons of struggle. The red bow of my agony has reached its target. The breeze carries my splendor like a fragrant rose. I dine at the gates of love's immensity, bedazzled by its light. Lantern carried. Thank you.
Wow. Always. So always listening to you is an experience like, you know, I mean, kaleidoscopic of emotions, you know, both in poems, your poems. Wonderful, lanterns. Always pleasure listening you and having you on the jazz.
Supriya. My Bayaji, Supriya.
Lantern has a kind of spirituality, you know, that transports you up, but seeks even the so-called love. I mean, sometimes I am thinking of our great poet Rabindranath Tagore, who was seeking love's edge even on the grass, the blade of the grass. Your first poem was encapsulating everything. There is celebration of life in it. Second one, dwelling on agony, again you are trying to transform it into the golden spiritual level.
Indeed. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Molly.
Yes, true. Truly, truly a lantern carrier.
Perfect. That's the name. So is the poem. Spirituality all around. Thank you, Lantern. And let me call upon the next poet, Jennifer. And Tanya, be ready. And Durga Chari will be coming next. So, Tanya. I am Jennifer.
Okay. Hi, everyone. I have a few poems. If it's over, goes the time, then tell me, please.
Yeah, if they are small, you could recite.
Yes, they're small.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Man, is that all? Man, you seduce woman, planting a child in her womb. She lovingly allows it to grow, giving birth to a new life. Her loving present to you. You, man, send it away to fight in wars, ridding it of its life. Your present to her, its corpse in a coffin shipped back home. Man, is that all woman is good for, giving birth to your statistics for war? My second poem, the first part of it was inspired by a photo of Badusev Paul when he invited us to do four lines. Fear not, my love. Fear not, my love. I'm not going to jump, though my head be contemplatively slumped below doomsday-like autumn skies, above man-made concrete jungles. I've climbed so I simply to get a feel for the birds that fly. Looking down at the lush valley beneath my feet, imagining the creatures crawling on the fertile soil, I feel at peace living in this nature wonderland. Lucky to be alive, happy to be alive, happy to be loved by you. I love you so much. Thus, fear not, my love. I am not going to jump below and leave you alone above, missing me, longing for me, shedding tears for me. Fear not, my love. And my last poem is titled Sucking. As a baby, I sucked on my mother's breast. I believe, no recollection. As a child, I sucked on my sweets, feeling heavenly, my recollection. As an adult, sadly, learning a new meaning of sucking. They are sucking the life out of me, the landlords, the bosses, the political establishment won't allow me to enjoy feeling free. They are continuously sucking the life out of me. Thank you.
Wow, what a powerful expression, powerful utterance. Wow. Beautiful rendition, Jennifer, as always. You know,
thank you. Love you. No? How picturesque, impactful your diction, your contents, as you said.
Thank you, Molly, my friend. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Molly, ma'am. Thank you, Jennifer. That's
welcome.
A wonderful
rendition. Thank you.
And now I would like to call upon Tanya.
Thank you very much, great poet Kumar Prasanna, for invitation and greeting to all the poets on the world. My first poem, A Song of Life. I would like my words to fly, to be full in of flowers to smell wonderful. Let them have their beginning and end in at last one day. May they have the gift of heavenly life, the gift of love and death. I would like my words to fly high to the sky, to become thunder to infinity, to vibrate with feelings, ringing to roll in the vacuum of the cemetery, to sing the song of the birth of the world, the song of warmth, the mothers of the earth, to become fireworks, ribbon colors to color the sky. I would like time to stop, just more bells to be heard, maybe the hearts of all people experience the blessing in the ecstasy of the world, but let it awake good in people in the unusually silence of words and bells. Echoes, planet of silence and gaze, let them cut the sky. Let the stars be seen during the day. Let people promise themselves that they wish the sun well. Thank you. And a second poem about love. Metaphysic. It is not physical love, but light is immeasurable. The feeling of love between two worlds who find themselves in the desert closed by disease of a difficult humanity. That love is metaphysical, where a woman wants to seduce a man to enter his dreams, and that he loves her with his light. Since when is light the original of the world? God's only. Thank you.
Wonderful, Tanja, wonderful.
Thank you.
Thanks for presenting your beautiful poems. Now I would like to call upon then our next poet, who is a teacher himself. He writes a wonderful poems in English and Telugu as well. His name is Durgachari. Please turn on your mic, sir.
What are you, sir?
Good evening, please.
Sir, this is Durgachari from Warangal. Hello.
Go ahead, sir. Go ahead.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Sir, is my slide audible, visible, sir?
Yeah, perfect, sir. Perfect. Perfect. Go ahead, sir.
Is this slide visible to all?
Yeah, perfect, perfect. Go ahead, sir. Go on reading your point.
Okay. See, sir. Say on the day of celebration of Golden Jubilee, Diamond Jubilee celebration of Indian independence, this poem has been written by me. The title of this poem is Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, the Urn of Elixir.
Go ahead, sir. Go ahead.
Okay. See, the title of my poem is Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, the Urn of Elixir. Born as a man of ignorance, that is based, and grown as the infant of innocence, in the midst of evolution of living beings on the earth, human beings as the epitome of supremacy in the creation. Just let me say it once again. Born as a man of ignorance, that is based, and grown as the infant of innocence, in the midst of evolution of living beings on the earth, human beings as the epitome of supremacy in the creation. A primitive man discovered the fire and changed the living style. By the advent of will, he brought about the Industrial Revolution. A ray of hope entered the darkness with the invention of electricity bulb by Edison. Through the ages of darkness, surpassed the human life before. Thinking processes made the man aware of discomforts and inconvenience of life and pierced into the darkness. Into the feudalistic and monarchical way of life on the earth, entered democracy by the people, for the people, and of the people. In the era of colonial reign, our mother India got rid of slavery by the efforts of great patriots, unsung heroes, and common freedom fighters. It is the 76th year redeemed, free, and liberated India has entered, being the Vishwaguru held for so many centuries, lost for many decades. Again, it's striving for it. Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav is being held, marching ahead towards winning the lost glory. We, the people of India and the world citizens, celebrate the unforgettable memories and moments of Amrit Mahotsav, making the urn of elixir, giving rebirth to the lost glory of Avibhakt Bharat with the spirit of liberty, equality, and fraternity. See, this is the poem written by me on the occasion of Diamond Jubilee celebration of Indian Independence Day. Thank you, one and all.
Undivided India, spirit of equality, liberty, and fraternity. Wonderful, sir. It's a poem presented on the occasion of, you know, Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. So I think that I would like to call upon next poet, Ratan Ghosh, who would like to to react on the poem and recite his poem as well. Ratan Ghosh, sir.
Good evening to all. Hello.
Good evening, sir. Good evening. Go ahead.
Good evening to everyone. Today I'm going to tell you another thing from my upcoming book. And I don't know how many poems can I read. Will I be allowed?
Yeah. You could read one poem, sir.
Okay. Upcoming book I'm reading again. On the same theme, I'm not going to describe it again. In the last week, I described the details regarding this, and I'm going to publish this book. By this year, I don't know, but still, I'm working on the book.
Sir, better if you could disconnect your headphones, sir, because you know you could directly talk in the, you know, using your phone. Yeah. Because you know it's giving a jarring sound. Yeah.
Am I audible now?
Yeah, perfect, perfect.
Okay. Let me see. 1 minute only. So today I'm going to read a poem from my upcoming book entitled Poland. Poland is a third poem from my book on the same theme, on the theme of banishment, loss, and being a refugee. One can feel it, the depth of, the anxiety that goes on in the lives of people who have to leave their country. So follow. I'm going to read it. Fire still burns. Fire still burns in the heart of a man who saw the rapids from his window pane. Who saw the rapids from his window pane. Being confined in the room of impending fear, being confined in the room of impending fear, just he heard the shrieks of near India. Just he heard the shrieks of who's in Odisha of near India. The drops of fresh blood he saw from the glass, the drops of fresh blood he saw from the glass. Never could he shout to save his dear ones. Never could he shout to save his dear ones.
The day died slowly in a pool of blood. The day died slowly in a pool of blood. Yeah, the day died slowly in a pool of blood. The setting plant slowly engulfed all the wings of beautiful hearts. The setting fire slowly engulfed all the wings of beautiful hearts. The dark, dead, and helpless evening. The dark, dead, and helpless evening kicked him off to flee. Thousands and thousands of tired steps strolling to the border of an unknown country. Houses drowned. Gardens drowned. Daughters, sisters, and mothers drowned, and drowned all holy, loving souls, and drowned all holy, loving souls in a land of their own, in a land of their own. The tired legs, like holy procession, slowly walking away beyond the shadow lines. The tired legs, like holy procession, slowly walking away beyond the shadow lines, leaving behind the shadows of all pleasures and pain. Leaving behind the shadows of all pleasures and pains, only to leave by the railway tracks, past slums and lanes. Only to leave by the railway tracks, past slums and lanes, with no window pane. With no window pane. They are now refugee clan. They are now a refugee clan in a city that just lost its own friend. In a city that just lost its own friends. Refugees they are now known. Refugees they are now known since they were brutally overthrown into a land of forlorn, into a land of forlorn. Yes, that happened. This is the history of Kolkata, actually, then Calcutta. The history of Jadavpur, you can say Shialdah, and other places. By the side of the railway tracks, thousands and millions of refugees from East Bengal had to get settled under a triple mat house. Triple means, or what I say. So they had nothing, without anything. They had everything. But after they had to leave their own land, when they crossed the border, they had nothing, even their shelter. So they had to leave by the railway tracks, paths, on roads, like refugees, like beggars. So on this theme, on my next book, upcoming book, Genocide, thank you for giving me this opportunity, Prasanna Kumar. I'm really fortunate to be here, this great source. Thank you.
In fact, we are fortunate to having you, sir. You know, for the poem that has been dedicated for refugees, and your poems always does the history, you know. thank you for, you know, that great imagery, and it's a, you know, kind of tribute, in fact, as a remembrance. I think we have a few poems. One poet left. I have two poets left. One is Isaac and one is Prasanna Bhatta, sir. I think I could go with Isaac. Isaac.
We have three poets left. One is Prasanna.
Oh my God. Yeah.
Today, my poetic friends, thanks a lot with a bunch of roses to Mr. Honorable Prasanna Kumar and Fertile Brains, who invited me to join this great platform. Really, I dedicated this poem to Ratan Ghosh. I dedicated this poem to Mr. Ratan Ghosh, and the title of my poem is Ratan Ghosh. Cruelty of naughty and haughty. Cruelty of naughty and haughty, nature of wicked people in this Halloween night. Cruelty of naughty and haughty nature of wicked people in this Halloween night. entrenchment, of entrapment to environment. Entrenchment of entrapment to environment among poison and pungent people. For their selfish nature, they are ready to do every evil. For their selfish nature, they are ready to do all evil. Beyond tolerance, seeing torment and torture of innocent people, feeling suffocated and choked my heart. Oh God, couldn't you rain flesh and bleach on bleeding hearts? Oh God, couldn't you rain flesh and bleach on bleeding hearts? Oh God, couldn't you show them the path to art, beautiful art? Oh God, make me a London career. Oh God, make me a London career of wisdom to lighten the path of ignorant system, for removing all barriers of dull and dumb, for removing all barriers of dull and dumb. Oh God, make me a London career of peace to pacify the pacification for giving solace. Oh God, make me a London career of peace to pacify the pacification for giving solace, for blooming humanity like I peace. Oh God, make me a London career of nonviolence, a supreme religion to rule in every region, for no need of violent way of invasion. For no need of violent way of invasion. Oh God, let my lantern lighten. Oh God, let my lantern lighten path towards heaven, to govern heart for building a heaven like heaven, where nonviolence and peace will govern, and peace will govern. This is the end of my poem. Thanks for reciting.
Wonderful, sir. Wonderful. Beautiful land and career. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. And now that I would like to call upon Issac. A Latin career, the poem is dedicated to you, sir. The peace poem. Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Yes. Thank you, Kumar. And thank you, all my friends in the world.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Yes. The first poem. As a coin, the wire pool, the sun's rays walk the ways of love. I saw my nymph close by a small fish. We cuddled in love, not mindful if it were true or imagined. Paradise awaits us. And the second, wait a minute. As a coin, love in the forest. Your laughter rolls like a galloping horse. Your face is smooth like a horse's tail. Let's ride on my horse to be free in the forest and create a newborn soul of peace and love. Let's hope so. And I want to speak about one bed and use for me because I'm a friend and the editor that published my content. My first poem in Israel was died yesterday. The name of her is Chava Pinchas Cohen. She was a poet and active of culture. And maybe God bless memory and rest in paradise. I read the poem that that she published me in Hebrew, and I write it in English. Behold a beard, my shoulder touches tea, to leap the forbidden distance. Behold the red heart, soul hold the string to draw the way to the storm of the events. Beard, behold my tear is frozen, and you behold, I am a beard, and you are me. Thank you, and maybe all my friends be alive very, very time and very ill and all happy.
Thank you, Isaac. Thanks for coming and thanks for your loving smile and congratulations on being published and rewarded for your poem. And
Prasanna, I did appreciate your namesake and my salutations and pranam to him. And I've written a lot in the chat. I just couldn't unmute. Thanks.
Yeah. Thank you. Yes, we almost have reached the end of the show. I think before winding up, I think I should read out a poem. So here is my poem. This is written randomly and means like, So given a theme and I just have written it. Rambling, I would say. Lantern for the city, yes. The streets dazzle as the boulevards adorned with fireflies. The bumblebees buzz around every nook and corner, humming with silent jingles of ecstasy. And the night birds of the city turn their vehicles on to scoot over and jive in. On the nights of waning moon, city lights greet one and all with a cherubic smile. Lopez, Ang, and Wold come and tap the feet in the mood of vibrant hues of even tides. The tides of ocean rejoice at the simmering spectacle. Night become days, the sounds in the cosmos reverberate the tones of excitement. Yes, the landscape of night bewitching to the hearts as the street lights peep through the passages of fairy cities. That's a prompt line given for some prompters. Thank you. Hope you all liked it. Roopali, ma'am, it's for you.
Prasanna, light is always awakening.
In fact,
and imagery is wonderful. You have worked it together in a wonderful way. The imagery is you are putting. Only thing was your rendering was a bit speedy. Otherwise, you would have focused on each and every image. You're a wonderful poet, Prasanna. I did one.
Yes, Samari. And a very, he doesn't want to, you know, read his poems out to us. But from now on, I think yes. From now on, we will start with your poem, Prasanna. Yeah. We'll begin the program with your poem. I think exactly. otherwise you're a very clever puppet here. You know, you're the guy who makes us dance to your tune. So you begin from now on, okay? That will be very nice. Now, thank you so much.
I wasn't thinking, it's Halloween. I should have read a poem appropriate for Halloween, but maybe I'll read that next time.
Yeah, sure. It's always yours, Scott.
Is this every week? You have this every week?
Yes, this is
every Sunday. And I really loved your poem, Scott. It was so, so true to what is happening around us, and I think it was such a powerful poem.
When one tries to be objective, to try to get at the facts without going to one side or the other.
Exactly.
Right now is the worst time, the worst time. I found, believe it or not, that people on the right are more tolerant of different ideas. You told me that 3 years ago, I would have laughed at you. But it's what I found.
Okay. True.
It
is a great evening. So I can enjoy every day. It was Prasanna, and I see how he looks at Prasanna along with the husband. You know, all poems were guided by the love's essence. And that was a beautiful evening today, you know.
Everything was there. Huh?
Yes.
I will stop for a moment. If you delete love and woman.
Yeah.
Thank you for your love and with all your...
If love and woman are deleted from poetry world.
With all your permission, with Roopali ma'am permission, I would like to ask Lushel to say a few words in conclusion of the evening. And welcome, Lushel.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much for your beautiful organization. Thanks, all the poets. Unless I will leave from you. Thank you.
I think I would like to ask you all to mute your mic so that, Lushel would talk. Yeah, Lushel. Lushel. She's gone somewhere. Is there? Lushel.
I was talking with my microphone muted. I'm so sorry. I was talking and talking. So thank you to everybody. Thank you, Prasanna. You do always a wonderful job. You're a perfect host and your poem is wonderful. So I agree. You should read as first so everybody can listen to you. I just want to say something that when poets come together, when there are these events, we talk in plural. We are not anymore alone behind our desks, alone with our words. We are a force. We can change things. I believe in this. And again, thank you to all of you for your inspiring verses. Love.
Thank you. On that note, thank you. We'll love to see you all next week.